Okay, it's time to test the reproducer and the strength of the motor on the Victrola 35. The service is done on it. Everything's greased up, put back in. And now we're going to, and the reproducer's been rebuilt with new gaskets and all of that. New diaphragm too, in this case. I just spent some records. I deliberately picked a few that are kind of rough. That's what I saved these for. Make the machine work for it. So if it's going to hang up too much on something, I'll know about it now, not later. It does have a brand new mainspring in there, so it's plenty of power in the motor. None of these are too horrible. I had one really rough one somewhere, but I don't know what I did with it. Oh, well. We'll just run these for now. A friend of mine just brought me a whole crate full of records here to test, so I will be going through them in the coming weeks and months and years and figuring out which ones are good. Now, one word of caution with these types of smaller machines with smaller horns, when you're playing electrically recorded records like this one, this is a Victor Electric, it can somewhat overwhelm the capacity of the horn. It's just a little dish back there. It's not some huge horn like on a Victrola 9 or something like that that can absorb all that extra fidelity and volume. These can sometimes blast a little too loud with this reproducer on a horn this side. Well, why am I taking the reproducer off that? We don't want to do that. Won't play very well without it. And that was Am I Blue? There you go. In case you wanted to know. Somebody always asks, what was that record? I don't ever remember later on, so there you go. What's on the flip side? Let me have my dreams. A waltz. These are roughly contemporary to this. They're probably a little bit newer than the machine, which is 1924, but that's okay. I put the warning in there about electrically recorded records. I know that the owner of this machine is using it for a living history demonstration where they're probably going to be playing a lot of Glenn Miller, Benny Goodman. You know, those later electrically recorded records can really blast sometimes. So what you want to do is use the smallest possible needle. You know, the low tone needles, the little ones. I don't have any here, otherwise I'd be using them. I had a bunch of them. I put them somewhere, and I don't remember where. So it was very helpful when I do that. Okay, let's stick a needle on there. Because these are the loud tone needles. It's a single spring, so let's wind it up. Dust on there. Okay. I'm trying to brush that with my... There we go. That one wasn't too much of a blasting record. Okay, next one is a comedian with a ukulele and a piano. Let's see what that's all about. Dust on there. Okay, Frank Crummett. Yeah, I guess so. Well, give it a try. A little bit of wear on that one. Maybe a little dirt too, dust. That'll make the motor work for it. So far, it hasn't had any problem. Well, it's only been one. I've actually played about 8 or 9 records on this already. And none of them have actually stopped the motor yet. I guess they weren't sufficiently worn enough. Oh, that's irritating. Okay, get a needle. Come on. Come on. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. A little bit of a wobble on that record.
Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Oh, how I miss the mud in Peoria, Peoria tonight. The knives and forks out in Peoria. Captain, we are lost. Our ship is wallowing in the sea. By wind and wave we're tossed. Lifeboats here and lifeboats there. Hear the shrieks and groans. The captain calls all hands on deck and sings in trembling tones. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Oh, how I miss the goyos in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Why, you can pick a morning gloria right off the sidewalks of Peoria. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight. What a song, what a song. Hear the wild applause. The big Manhattan Opera House is crowded to the doors. Bravo here and bravo there. Bravo with a bang. Signor Cutsy sang a song, and this is what he sang. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Oh, how I miss the flies in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Why should I sing about Peoria, Doria, when I can sing about Peoria? Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight. Oh, how I miss the girls in Peoria, Peoria tonight. I've got a brother in Peoria, works in the 5 and 10 Centauria. Oh, how I wish I was in Peoria, Peoria tonight.
Odd. But not too bad. Okay. Let's see, a little dust come off of that one too. Stick that out of the way where it won't get cracked or broken. And who's next? Okay. There you go. That's who's next. Actually, that's side B. Why don't we slide one? Side A. See what's on side A first. Okay, I'm gonna stick something under the corner of this thing so it's not wobbling like that and thumping and bumping when I. That's better, hopefully. When I crank it. There we go. That's better. Oops. I don't want to take the needles from the spent pile. Defeats the purpose of changing needles. Remember the rules. Change your needle for each play of a record. Needles are cheap. Records are irreplaceable. Oop. Almost got my finger caught. So far, so good. And I found the record I had that was pretty worn. I'll play that one next. See if we can make it shut down. Already showed that one, didn't it? Whoopsie. Yeah, that's good. That's an excellent way to treat the reproducer. Dumbass. Okay. Now we need a needle. Notice this little stand over here? That's what it's for. That's to hold your reproducer while you do this. Just don't forget when you close the lid that it's there. Otherwise, crunch. Okay. A little dust on there. That's all right. Thing.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, put the brake on. All right. Let's see. The next one is a Billy Murray record. And it, like many Billy Murray records, he was a headliner in his time. His records got played a lot. And often they end up pretty worn. Now, this one only looks that way. It may not be worn at all, just on the surface, or it might be down in the grooves. You know, your mother's gone away to join the army. You see, it's kind of dull looking. You can see, yeah, that may be enough to stop it. Probably wouldn't stop the 9, but it definitely stopped the small motors these portables use. So, this, the Victor Victrola 50, and so on. They use little motors, small springs, the Victrola 4. Those are the smallest springs that Victor uses. So, they don't have a whole lot of power. Because they were made to play brand new records. Yeah, 100 years ago. This is 100 years old, actually. This machine is actually 100 years old, exactly. A century. And it still plays. You know, I have a feeling my phone is not going to be still playing 100 years from now. I know I won't still be playing 100 years from now. But this will probably still be playing 100 years from now. Would not surprise me at all. Billy Murray, your mother's gone away to join the army. Okay, I wonder if we'll try the other side. That actually played a lot better than I expected it to. See, you can never really tell until you play these records how they're going to play. Just because they look like they're worn doesn't necessarily mean that they are. Sit down, you're rocking the boat, Billy Murray. Oh, wait a minute. It would really help if I put a needle on there first, before trying to play the record. Okay. fingers under there and not get stabbed while doing it. Sit down, you're rocking the boat. Okay, that also played a lot better than I thought it would. Again with appearances. You never can tell till you actually play them. If any machine was going to be shut down by one record, it would be one with the smaller motor that these have. Let's see. What is this Sweet Man thing? Isham Jones, we'll try that. It's called a Charleston dance. I think I might have played the other side of this already on another machine, but it looks familiar. Okay, we got noise accompanying us in the background. Nothing we can do about that. The neighbors are doing something. Thank you. I guess I could hear a little bit of the Charleston in there. Let's see, get that out of there. Dust. Now this one, I don't know what this is. Let's see. If I had my way, Merrill Johnson and his Seco Couriers. I think that's what this one I gotta be a little careful on, because as you can see, there is the camera picking that up? Yeah, there's a dimple on the end. You see that? It's crumbling. It's a very thin layer of shellac on these records. And if I try to ride the needle on the outside, it's going to catch it and make a mess. Come on, get on the spindle. What are you doing to me here? There we go. So I'm going to try to very carefully place it in the first groove without it bouncing and scratching, as it's going to want to do. Okay, let's see, we're gonna get it. Perfect. Well, we might as well do the flip side. Why not, since it's already here? And the flip side is... Where the sweet forget-me-nots remember. Okay. Notice we have a clip on here now. You need to have that clip so this turntable doesn't flop around when you're carrying the machine. That's important. A lot of times they get broken or lost with time. And when that happens, you have to source one. In my case, it came off of an old parts machine, which I believe was an HMV 101. Same clip, in case you were wondering. Camera a little bit there, doesn't fall off. Got a needle, we do. I think that'll do it for now. I'm going to end up playing more records on this, but that'll be later. It's starting to get late in the day, and I'm starting to think about food. This stows back here, like so. You notice the lid stay is on there now. You need to have that so the lid doesn't flop around. And then this handle right here goes. There's a hole here, which I and like there. See? Come on. Come on. Don't be a pain in the neck. They usually are. There we go. And then it clips right in there. That's where the handle stows. Take that out of there. It's a good idea if you're not going to play the machine anymore for the end of the day. Just let it wind down. No reason to keep tension on the spring. I mean, if you're going to play it again, it's not critical. It's already half wound down anyway, but I could have left it because I am going to play it more tomorrow. But still, I want to teach good habits. If you're going to put the machine away for a few weeks, months, or years, let the spring wind down. The only time I don't recommend you do that entirely is with some of the oldest versions of the Victrolas, like from the mid-teens on down, like 1917 on down, where they have the pear-shaped hole on both ends of the spring. What can sometimes happen if the spring is an old original is if you unwind it all the way, it may lose its tension where it holds onto the spring arbor and it'll just release and then it won't catch on the pin there to tighten back down again. Now you're screwed. You have to change the spring. You have to open it up anyway. Well, you're going to open it up. You're going to try to reclamp it, you know, squeeze it a little so it holds onto the arbor better. It's not going to work. It rarely ever does. And you're going to have to get a new spring to put on there. What I do with those older machines, just as a precaution, I never let it wind down all the way. I let it wind down 90% and leave a little tension on the spring to make sure that it doesn't slip off its arbor. Because I've had it happen. My Victrola 16 did that, and so did the Victrola 9 that has the triple spring motor in it, the custom job. Same exact motor, same springs, it's a 1912 motor. And in both cases, I ended up replacing all three main springs in both machines. And that took care of the problem. Brand new main spring doesn't have that. That you can wind down all the way and not really worry about it. Just something to remember. All right, I guess we can call this a night. The machine is playing, and mechanically, it is finished.